You might notice that the names and district numbers you've been seeing on campaign signs this election season don't always look familiar. That's because Mahaska County and all Iowa counties have been affected by redistricting. Redistricting is really all about representation. The Supreme Court requires that each U.S. House district has roughly the same population, but populations shift and change.
That means after a 10-year period of the previous census, some states gain seats and need to redraw the lines, and some states lose seats.
That's William Penn Assistant Professor Greg Marco. He says this year Iowa lost a seat in the House, going from 5 districts to 4.
Iowa almost lost a seat in 2000. There's a complex mathematical formula to determine who loses seats, and we almost lost it last time, so we knew we were going to lose a seat this time. So we have to redraw the lines at least for that. But even if a state doesn't lose representation, internal population shifts within a state also occur, so the lines do have to be withdrawn anyway every 10 years after a census.
Mahaska County used to be part of the old 3rd District. Here's Oskaloosa on the old map in the same district as Des Moines. Leonard Boswell is our representative in Congress right now. But since redistricting, the county is now part of the 2nd District along with Iowa City and the Quad Cities, and will vote in the 2nd District race between incumbent Democrat Dave Loebsack and Republican challenger John Archer. Marco tells us that redistricting always has political implications. For instance, the new districts initially pitted 2 Democrat incumbents, Dave Loebsack and Bruce Braley, against each other in District 1. Loebsack solved that problem by moving a short distance to Iowa City in District 2. The 3rd District race has 2 incumbents facing off, Democrat Leonard Boswell and Republican Tom Latham. And redistricting is not limited to the congressional districts. The districts for Iowa House and Iowa Senate were also redrawn as a result of the most recent census. As we told you earlier in the newscast, incumbent Guy Vanderlinden is running for re-election in District 79. He currently represents District 75.